Hello people! You might have heard about SQL, which is a structured query language used to extract data from a relational database. Relational databases are usually stored in the form of tables, but in the real world, we want to store data in the form of documents, trees, and even graphs. This is where NoSQL or not only SQL helps. As the name suggests, NoSQL databases store the data in non-tabular formats. There are various types of NoSQL databases. Let's check them one by one. Key value database stores the data in form of key value pairs. The database contains unique keys and the values associated with those keys. We can query the database by passing the key, and the database will return the value corresponding to that key. BerkeleyDB, Dynamo, and Redis are some examples of key value databases. This type of database is often used for caching data. Wide column database stores the data into flexible columns, which can be spread across different servers. The query to find specific column values can be executed very fast. That is why it is also called a column-oriented database. Cassandra, Google Bigtable, and HBase are examples of wide column databases. This type of database is often used to store time series data. Document database stores data in the form of field value pairs. Values can be of any type, like string, number, date, array, or even object. Document can be stored in the form of JSON, BSON, or XML. Amazon DocumentDB and MongoDB are examples of document databases. This type of database is often used to store PDF files in the form of JSON for better querying. Graph database stores data in which entities are related to each other. Information for entities is stored in the nodes of the graph, and the relationship between entities can be stored along the edges. Amazon Neptune and Neo4j are examples of graph databases. This type of database is often used for social networking applications. Overall, NoSQL is a very powerful paradigm for databases, and it is easier to scale. I hope you found this video helpful. I request you to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and comment down what you want to watch next. See you in the next one.